I like building things, making things, fixing things. I'm big on thinking it and you will achieve it. We have a funny little clip. I call it my theme video. You know, every good hero needs a theme song, right? Seeing all of the different instruments and missions that I've been a part of or solve huge problems is never something that I started out to do. Here at the NASA Goddard Space Flight Center, I started off doing attitude control systems. We don't say spacecraft having a bad day, but really position and location in space. So often people will call me a rocket scientist because I built and designed systems to control our spacecraft. And then moved into instrument management. I'm really the taskmaster in helping people meet the criteria that a scientist needs to create the cool stuff that you see around us. I was born in Brooklyn, New York. I grew up in Bed-Stuy. As we say, Bed-Stuy, do or die. I liked math from the very beginning. I played team sports. I still continue to do softball. My comic book favorite is the Caped Crusader. They used their brain and I could too. I moved to Cambridge, Massachusetts for high school. I applied to MIT and got in. But when I graduated from MIT, it was the year of the first shuttle disaster. And that was really hard. And jobs really weren't available at NASA. I went back to school. When I graduated from Howard University, I was the first African-American female to get a PhD in mechanical engineering. At NASA Goddard Space Flight Center, we have four science disciplines: helio, earth science, astrophysics, and planetary science. I've worked all different phases of the mission. One of my favorite projects is a lunar reconnaissance orbiter, because when I was in first grade, we got to see men go to the moon. It's a satellite that is basically using a laser, what we call a laser altimeter, to measure distances very accurately. You point the laser altimeter down to the surface and then bounce very quickly back up into your detectors and measuring that time and the distances. We're able to create three-dimensional maps of the moon, so you can see the very small craters down to 3 centimeters in resolution. That is very impactful when you begin to think about traveling in space. You need to know where you're going and where you're going to land. The James Webb Space Telescope is our next huge telescope. And we're hoping that it will actually take that same type of science and data that we've been collecting for Hubble and take it to the next level. It's 28 years in the making. So when they started the concept, the technology did not even exist. When we're looking at things in space, but we're looking way back in time, we're just finally getting the light. Different frequencies of light give us different clues. Infrared happens to be one of those spectral bands of light. With the James Webb Space Telescope would give us some insight as to how quickly Milky Way is expanding, or even how long ago the universe was born. So for myself, this new position that I am, it's really being strategic about what NASA should be doing for the future. We may use sensors that look down at the Earth right now, but they may serve a purpose for us in the Martian environment or moon environment. As we try to figure out how to live on this big blue marble, we're going to succeed by working together. Diverse ideas spark innovation. They collide and create great solutions.